Our next speaker is a retired emergency room physician and a medical director from Treasure Lake, who was among us all on July 13th when chaos ensued. Despite that chaos, his instincts and training kicked in. When others were in need, he stepped forward to help. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me now in welcoming Dr. James Sweetland to the podium.
Hello, Butler, Pennsylvania. I love you too. Thank you. My name is Dr. James Sweetland. I had the opportunity to take care of Corey Comprator during the last Butler rally. The fact that all you are here makes you all heroes. You're standing up for your candidate and the right to celebrate your candidate. Please give yourself a big round of applause. You deserve it. In speaking today, I have to give you two disclaimers. First one is that the opinions that you hear from me today are mine and mine alone. They do not represent the organizations I work for, UPMC, Lock Haven, or Schumacher Clinical Partners. Having said that, I have another disclaimer. I used to be a Democrat. Please forgive me for that. I want to give you a quick thumbnail sketch of who I am. I graduated Penn State undergraduate. And I went to Hershey Medical School. We are... Thank you. Now be careful, J.D. Vance is going to be out here at 4:30. While I was in medical school, I started the Harrisburg Free Clinic to serve the underserved poor in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. That went on and is now still in operation since 2002 as Lion Care in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Thank you. I point that out because if three naive medical students can start a free clinic, any of you can. If you're committed, you can do a lot for your community. And I'm going to ask you at the end of this speech to do something. It's for Donald Trump as well as for yourself and your community. July 13th was a day a lot like today, a little bit warmer. The sound system was incredible. I thought I was at a rock concert, but there was no weed. I was sitting over the stands over here. They were positioned farther back, and I was enjoying the day. About an hour before Trump came out, a woman was with heat exhaustion down in the lower stands. My wife texted me and said, "Why aren't you helping that woman?" You know that text you get from your wife? So I said, "Yeah, where?" She said, 12 rows down, dummy. So I went down to help her, and up showed Rico Elmore. He helped me as a hero. He helped me with that woman. Hey, Rico. When Donald Trump hit the stage, he came out, he was like a rock star. The crowd was jubilant. Everybody was enjoying his speech. He's very charismatic. About 7 minutes into the speech, shots rang out. There are three pops. At first I thought there were firecrackers, followed by a pause of about 3 seconds, followed by four more. Like all Pennsylvanians, I looked to see where the shots were coming from. Pennsylvanians are used to guns. We like to hunt. So we're not afraid. Are we? So I have to hurry along. I'm getting a message. I'm speaking too long. But as those shots rang out, I saw his personal detail cover him with a human pyramid, that was a slip. Human, I'm a doctor, forgive me. He was covered by a pyramid of humanity. I then heard very clearly a woman cry out, "He's been shot, he's down." For those of you in the audience that are EMS, raise your hands. Thank you. You are heroes every day. As you know, EMS, that's a signal, I need your help now. Don't wait. Come help me right now. I hesitated. Then I heard a voice, loud, clear, rich, and reassuring. It spoke to me. It said, "Go. Go. They need your help." I hesitated. The voice said, "Why are you waiting? Go." I'm telling you right now, that was the voice of God. I came and rendered aid as best I could to Corey Compitore. I did not know who he was. He's a large man, about 6'2", about 200 pounds. And I was aided again by Rico Elmore and another Air Force vet by the name of Ed Shear. I'm calling you guys out. You are awesome. I've been called a hero many times over for my actions that day. I've struggled with that title. I think I'll struggle with it for some time, because in the pantheon of heroes, I'm at the bottom rung. Corey Compitore is at the top. I am honored to be mentioned in the same breath as Corey. I'm honored that you are here and clapping for me. But I want to say that each one of you are heroes. And I'm going to ask you to do something that will change this campaign and guarantee that Donald Trump is going to be elected our next president of the United States. It's simple to hear, but it is might be a little bit harder to do. Each one of us knows at least two people that do not share our political views. You know them. Call them up and say, "We need to turn down the temperature in the room. An assassin's bullet should not decide our election." I wish and I want for you and I to speak about our differences in a civil and respectful manner. Now, you know, I know what you're going to say. I'm going to have to talk to a Democrat. You're looking at a former one right now. I'm here to tell you, if you do that, and I've done that to five different people, the results will be amazing. They will surprise you. And I'm going to leave you with one last thought. Democrats are like teenagers. When you talk to them, you don't think they're listening, but they really are. Thank you, Butler, Pennsylvania. Stay Butler strong. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's keep that round of applause going for Dr. James Sweetland.